Hello everyone and once again welcome to my channel Engineering Made Simple. Now as you all know we were studying digital system design and in that we were studying about combinational circuits. So this is part 5 of the lecture on combinational circuits. The links for the remaining previous parts I will paste it in the description and from clicking the link in the description you can go to that part. So in today's class we are going to study about combinational circuits and more specifically about encoder circuits. So unlike many other combinational circuits like your multiplexers, demultiplexers, your encoders are also available in IC form. But first let us understand the basic working of an encoder circuit. So this is the basic block diagram of an encoder. So this is the basic block diagram of an encoder. Now have a look, close look at this. This encoder is also a combinational circuit. Now this is its block diagram. This is an encoder block which has n input lines, and corresponding to n input lines there are m output lines available. So there are n input lines and there are m output lines. So an encoder can be defined as a circuit which takes n bit binary word or n bit word as an input and gives m bit word as an output. Now what is the meaning of that this term word? Word is nothing but group of bits. It is known as a word in your digital system. So basically an encoder is a circuit which will produce m bit binary word at the output. So this m bit output will be generated from the encoder circuit corresponding to input n bit digital word. Now what is its function? Now from the term only it means encode. When we say encode, we are supposedly saying that we are coding something in some format. Now there are n input lines over here. So now as we were doing when I was teaching you number systems, we did some conversions, that is conversion from one number system to another and conversion from one code to another. So how we did that? Whenever we had a number in the decimal number system, we converted it to a binary code. Now this is so its equivalent BCD representation would be 0010. Because in BCD representation, we represent each decimal digit by its 4-bit binary equivalent. So this is your BCD code. So this task I have done manually by my knowledge of your number systems or Boolean algebra or number systems used in digital electronics. But I want this thing to be done mechanically with the help of this digital electronic chip. So this task is nothing but encoding a decimal number into binary coded decimal. So what I have done manually is decimal to BCD. Or in other words, I can say that I have encoded a single bit decimal number to a 4-bit BCD number. So this is known as a task of encoding. And this is what this encoder block does. So suppose thing I have I have decimal numbers as the input, it will give me 4-bit BCD numbers as the output, corresponding output. So basically it is used to convert n bit code word into some another code format. So that is conversion of one code into another code in another format is known as encoding, and the combinational circuit which performs this task is known as an encoder. Well, there are various types of encoders available. Now there is one more thing to note over here. So there are various types of encoders available. So there are different types of encoders available. Types of encoders available. So when there are these types of encoders available, so these are the different types of encoders available. First one is octal bit, decimal, to BCD encoder. Okay, then the second one we have is octal to binary encoder, and this both these encoders are available in your integrated circuit form, that is IC form. IC number I will tell you when we will discuss each of the following in detail, but for timing remember these are the two encoders in IC form. Now we will discuss each of the following encoders. There is also a third type of encoder, which is hexadecimal to binary encoder. So from this only it is pretty much clear that when you have input decimal number, it converts into output BCD equivalent, the circuit that is encoder. When we give input octal number, it gives me binary output, so m bit binary output. So that is what is the function of the encoder. So I am going to discuss these two in detail. The third one you can do it on your own. So I am going to discuss only decimal to BCD encoder and octal to binary encoder in this class. Now, if you want me to discuss hexadecimal to binary encoder, please comment in the comment section so that I will make a separate lecture on this. But if you understand these two, then this is pretty much on similar lines. So, and before moving on to these two types of encoders, I would like to explain you one more concept, which is known as priority encoder. Now remember, this was a block diagram. Of our encoder, generalized block diagram. These specific cases I will discuss later. So this is your encoder block, right? So this was your encoder block, which has n input lines, and there are m output lines. Now what does a priority encoder mean over here? Now you know that there are here some let's say n input lines. Now among these n input lines, some will have higher priority. Let's say if this one particular line number 1 here in this case has some higher priority, so this is a generic block diagram, and the LSB bit of the input has the lowest priority. Let us take this for as a general example. Okay, so which input will have high or low priority is given in the data sheet of the particular encoder IC. So you need to refer to the data sheet of the particular encoder IC, but I am explaining for the generalized case. So let us assume if this particular, that is MSB bit of the input, has high priority, and if this has a lower priority, then this particular bit input will be encoded first. So the bit if this input is high activated and this input is also high activated in that case. Activated meaning logic 1 is applied at this particular input. So the input having high priority will be encoded first. What is the meaning of encoded first? So it would be encoded into the output first. So, because that particular input has a higher priority. So, if both the inputs are higher, then first the input line with high priority will be encoded into the encoded as the output first. So, that is known as priority encoding concept. And mostly these ICs which are available in the market, both decimal to BCD encoder and octal to binary encoder, they are available in priority encoder form only. So now let us move on to study the specific cases now. So now we have first type is decimal to BCD encoder. Alternative name for this is 10 is to 4 encoder. Why 10 is to 4? Because you know in decimal digits or decimal code word it is of 10 digits, so it will have 10 input lines. So this stands for number of input lines in this, and 4 because in BCD, that is binary coded decimal, every decimal digit is represented by its 4 bit binary equivalent. So this 4 indicates the number of output lines. So as the decimal to BCD encoder has 10 input lines and 4 output lines, it is 10 is to 4 encoder, also known as 10 is to 4 encoder, and it is also available in IC form, and the IC number for this particular encoder is IC 74147. So this is available in priority encoder form, but it performs the same task, but it will implement the concept of priority encoder also, which I explained just now. So now let us start designing a decimal to BCD encoder. So whenever we are designing any combinational circuit, first step is to write its truth table. Now let us write down its truth table. Now what is the input? Decimal. Now as you know, decimal code has digits from 0 to 9 in decimal. So when I say write the truth table, input will be your decimal, output will be your, okay, what will be your output? 4 bit binary. So this is your input decimal. I am writing the truth table directly over here, and output BCD equivalent. And output will be BCD equivalent. So I am writing it over here. Output in form of BCD, it would be 4 bits, right? D, C, B, and E. So if I want to represent this decimal to binary encoder in terms of block diagram, the simplest one will be IC 74147. Encoding form. Now let us see this. So this is the generalized, this is not the generalized, sorry, this is block diagram of 10 is to 4, that is BCD to decimal to BCD encoder. So this is decimal to BCD encoder. So it has 10 inputs, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Because there are decimal numbers, right? Decimal to BCD. So like this and so on up to 9, till 9. And for this corresponding 9 outputs, there are 4 outputs. What I have labeled in the truth table? So this will be your D, C, B and A. So that will be my 4 bit BCD. Okay. And this will be my 10 bit decimal. So this is my decimal to BCD generalized block diagram. So there are 9 decimal inputs, and corresponding to 9 decimal inputs, there are 4 bit corresponding BCD outputs. Now let us write this part over here. Inputs 0, 1, 2, 3. These all are decimal numbers, and that's why I am writing it directly. So if you want to mention its base, you can write it. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And corresponding to that is BCD equivalent. So 0, 0, 0, 0. And what is 1 in BCD is 0, 0, 0, 1. BCD is nothing complicated, just 4 bit binary representation of its decimal equivalent. So 2 is represented as 0, 0. 10. It is nothing but decimal to binary conversion, you see. There is no need to get confused. 0, 0, 1, 1 stand for P. 0, 1, 0, 0 stands for 4. 0, 1, 0, 1. 0, 1, 1, 0. 0, triple 1. 8 stands for 1, triple 0. And 9 stands for 1, 0, 0, 1. So now we have developed a truth table. Now it's time for us to implement the circuit diagram for this. What will be inside of this block diagram, or what will be the inside combinational circuit inside this IC block. So now let us start with this implementation. So for implementation of any circuit, we need its output equations. But have a look at this. Whenever we have some output, whenever we want to output equations, and we have a truth table, we go for K-map. But in this case, K-map is not required because we can directly write the mean terms in terms of addition. Now let's see how we can write. Now if I want to write the equation for output equation for D, output equation for output BCD output D, because this is the output, right? So this is the output B. So for D, how will you write? See the columns where the output goes 1. So here, corresponding to decimal equivalent 4, here output for 8 and 9 only it is 1. For decimal equivalents of 8 and 9 only, D column is 1 and 1. So what will be here its output? It would be, as this is the input, I will write it directly as 8 plus 9. See, because for these 2 bits only, the output goes high. That is 8 and 9. These 2 digits only, the output goes high. Now similarly, let us write output equation for C. Now C, we see C is high for D4. That is decimal digit 4, decimal digit 5, decimal digit 6, and decimal digit 7. So it would be 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. Okay. Then, now let us write output equation for B. So wherever B goes high, 6 and 7. So it would be 6 plus 7. And C, A is high for decimal digits 2 and 3. So it would be discussing from decimal digit D. So for decimal digit D, it was correct. It was 8 plus 9 because only output is high for 8, corresponding to 8 and 9 for in the D's column. So here it is correct, that is 8 plus 9. Now let us write for C. Again we have, here it is 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. So for C only it was correct. I think I made a mistake while writing for D. Okay. So B is nothing but 2 plus 3. Okay, 2 plus 3 and then 6 plus 7. Okay, 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 7. And now let us write the output equation for A. So, 1 is at 1, 1, 1, this one corresponds to this one, this 2 corresponds to this 2, this 4 corresponds to. So this will be 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. So these are the output equations for the 4 output BCD outputs. That is for DCBA we have this particular output equations. Now let us implement this circuit. So for implementation part, I am erasing the truth table. Those who have not written the truth table, please write it down. And I am implementing the circuit over here. So now I am implementing the circuit using basic gates. So let us do its implementation using basic gates. The implementation implementation of your decimal to BCD encoder. Now we have the output equations. So we had 9 inputs, right? So let us draw input lines, decimal inputs. So these are particularly the input lines, okay? So this is 0, this is line for 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8 and 9. So this 9 are nothing but your decimal input. Keep this thing in mind. So these are my decimal input. Now have a look at this output expression. Now I want to implement the circuit using basic gates for this particular, for D output, that is this in the generalized block diagram is. So I want circuit implementation for this. Now D is nothing but addition between decimal digits 8 and 9. So let us do that here. 8 and 9 is connected to this particular. Let me draw this more properly. So this is your output D. It is nothing but 8 plus 9. So this is the first equation. Now the second equation is for output C. 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. And this is your BCD output, okay? Decimal inputs, BCD outputs. So now, for solving for B, we have 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. That is 4. Here it is. Plus 6. So here again I will tap from 6. Four plus five plus six plus seven. And this I will connect to an OR gate, which will give me C, which is 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. This is shorted over here, this is connected over here, this is connected. Now cross indicates connection to that input line, okay? Now for output B we have to write 2, that is 2 input line to this. Plus 3 plus 6 plus 7. So this will give me my B output, which is 2 plus 3 plus 6 plus 7. Correspondingly, I have to connect those things by putting a cross over here. Now, last but not the least, A input. Our 8 is 1 plus 3 plus 5.
1.
Plus 7 plus 9, 7 and 9 is 0. 1 this is from 9, okay? So let us connect this with respective input. And we will connect another OR gate. Because addition is there for OR gate. So here it is. A is nothing but 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. So this we obtained from the truth table. So this is the circuit diagram implementation of it.